In today's video, we're going to look at renaming documents. I'm going to show you several tips on how we can rename documents. Everything from renaming a single document, how we can easily do that, to renaming multiple documents. Now, if you like this video, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can support my efforts in creating these videos. Let's take a look at how we can rename documents on the Mac. Now, the first tip we're going to look at is renaming a single document. Let's say you have a document you want to rename it. How do you do that? Well, all we have to do is just select the document. So I have this document here selected. I'd like to rename this to Cactus. So I have it selected. Just click on it one time. You don't open it up. Just click on it one time. And then from here, all you have to do is just hit the return key. And when you do, it's going to select the name. Now, it is not going to select the extension being the JPEG. You don't want to change that. This is how the Mac knows what to open it up with, what type of document it is. But what it does do is it selects the first part of the name. So from here, all I have to do is just type in Cactus. And now, when I hit the return key again, we can see that we renamed it. If a name has multiple words, it'll select all those words. When we go over to this document here, I click on it once to select it, and then I hit the return key, you can see that it selected every word in there. It did not select the extension again. We can do the same thing when we're looking at a Finder window. So let's go over to my downloads. I would like to rename this file here. I select it, and then I hit the return key, and we can see it selected the entire name, but it did not select the extension. So now all I need to do is just start typing and it'll replace that name. Now we can do the same thing with the contextual menu. All we have to do is just go over to the document we want to rename. I control click on it. And then from here, you're going to see rename. And when I rename it, it selects the entire name. It will not select the extension. In this next tip, we're going to see how we can rename a file from within the application. Let's go back over to my Mac. So I have this document here. I'm just going to double click on it. It's going to open up in the preview app. We can see the name here. Now, what I would like to do is rename it from within the app. I don't want to go into the Finder. I would like to just rename it right now. Well, we have a couple of different ways to do that as well. I can go up under File here, and then you're going to see Rename. And when I select this, it allows me to rename it. So let's just call this Cactus 2. And now I hit return, and now that has been renamed. Another way is right through the window. So when I go back over to my Mac here, you're going to see that I have Cactus here. Let's just say I wanted to rename this to Cactus 3. Well, all I need to do from within the application, I'm in my application here, preview. All I need to do is just go over to the title here. And when I move my cursor over top of it, we get a little caret to the right. That's what this little arrow pointing down is. When I see that little caret, all I have to do is just click on this and I can go and rename it. So now I just change this to 3 and we've renamed it. I can do the same thing with this document here. I double click on it, it's going to open up. And then from here I can go up under File and rename it. Or what I can do is just go over to the title here. And when I move my cursor over top, you're going to see I have that little caret again. If I move it away, it disappears. So I just move it to where that little caret shows. And once I do that, when I click on it, I can go and rename it. So we can rename it from within the application as well. So that's how we can rename a single file. We can do it from within the Finder or from within the application. But what about multiple files? Let's say we wanted to rename multiple files. How can we do that? Well, we can do that through the Finder, and there's actually several options for this. And the first option, what we're going to do is see how we can replace text. Replace text within the name. Let's go back over to my Mac. So I have this folder here, and what it has here is a number of images in it. Now, if we look at the naming here, you're going to see that the first one says IMG underscore. But all the other ones say P. So what I would like to do is I would like to have a consistent name here. So what I would like to do is replace the letter P here with IMG underscore. So then it's all named kind of the same. How can I do that? Well, the first thing we need to do is we need to select the files that we want to rename. So I don't select all of these. All I need to do is select the ones that I want to rename. So from here, I select the first one, and then I go over to the last one here, and if I hold down the Shift key, it allows me to select all of those files. So I have all of them that I want to rename. Now what I do is I use my contextual menu, Control key and click, and you're going to see rename, just like what we did when we renamed a single file. But being that I have multiple files selected, it's going to give me different options. So now I select this, and then from here, you're going to see that I can replace the text. Now, under this menu here, we can replace the text, we can add text, or what we can do is we can format. Let's first look at replace text. So I just select replace. Now what I need to do is I need to search for what I want to replace. So in my case here, I want to replace the letter P. So I type in here P. And then what do I want to replace it with? Well, I want to replace it with IMG underscore. So now if we look here, you're going to see I have the IMG underscore. So it's going to replace all of these that I have selected where there is the letter P. It's going to replace it with IMG underscore. And we can actually get a little preview here. So that's what I want. So now all I need to do is just select rename. And when I do, we can see that we now have IMG underscore where we had the P. So that's how we can replace the text in name. We search and replace. So that's how we can search and replace text in a name. Now, what if you wanted to just add text? You don't want to replace the text. You would just like to add text. Well, that's what we're going to look at in this next tip. If we go back over to my Mac and we go over to my files here, what I would like to do is add presentation to this name. I want to add it before the name. So how do I do that? Well, again, we need to select the files that we want to rename. Well, in this case, I want to rename all of them. So I'm just going to use Command A, and then I have them all selected. Now I get to my contextual menu, I control click, and we go over to rename. And then from here, what we need to do is we need to make sure that we select add text. You're going to see when I click on this, I have my replace text, add text, and format. We need to go to add text. Once I select add text, we just go and type in what we want to add. So I'm just going to go with presentation here. And then from here, what we do is we select, do we want it before the name or do we want it after the name? Well, I want it before the name. So I go before the name. Now you're going to see that we have this little preview again or an example. And what I would like to do is add a space there. So then presentation is on its own. So I just go back over here and I type in a space. And now we can see we have presentation space and then the image name. So now all I need to do is just click on rename. And you can see we have presentation there. Let's go ahead and make this a little bit wider. And now we have my space in there. So that's how you can add text. You can add it before or you can add it after a name. And the last tip for renaming, we're going to look at how we can format it. When we format it, what we're able to do is add consecutive numbers or add the date to it. So let's go back over to my Mac and see how we do this. So I have my images here. And what I would like to do is rename these. Actually, what I want to do is I just want to call these presentation 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I just want to get rid of all of these numbers here. How can I do that? Well, again, we just need to select them. I have them all selected. Command A to select them all. I'm going to rename them all. And then we go over to our rename here. And then from there, we go over to format. When we select format, we have a number of different options here. This is going to change the format of the text. It's not going to change the format of the document. It's just going to change the format of the text, the name. So from here, I can select my name format. What is it going to be? Well, we can have it be name and index, which means it's going to be photos 1, photos 2, photos 3, photos 4, or what I can do is put it before the name. So now it's going to be 1 photo, 2 photo, 3 photo, 4 photo. I like to have it after the name. And then I select where I want to start the numbering at. We're just going to go with 1, and now it's going to be photos with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So let's go ahead and rename that. And we can see we have photos 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's take another look at that to see what other options we have with format. So I select rename. And this time what we're going to do is we're going to go name and counter. So I select it. And now, instead of 1, 2, 3, 4, what I'm able to do is have it be 0, 0, 1. So it's more of a counter. This is great if you want to sort it alphabetically. So it's going to sort it by number. And then I can also put the date in there. So I go name and date, and now we can see it'll put the date in there. And again, I can select where I want it after the name. Let's go ahead and rename it. And now we can see we have the date and time in there. So those are the different ways that we can rename our documents on the Mac. We can rename it from within the Finder, we can rename it from within the document, and we can easily rename multiple files at once. We can search and replace text, or we can just replace the text, and then we can also index it. So that's how we rename files on the Mac. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is share it with your friends and family, like it, or even subscribe to my channel. You may also want to check out my site, danstutorials.com. Although I have about 400, 450 videos on YouTube, I have over 2,100 videos on my site, danstutorials.com. I've been making these videos for my site a lot longer than I have for YouTube. When you go over to my site, I do have a membership option. This is a way that you can help support my efforts. If you become a member of my site, you will see all of the videos ad-free. I take out all of the ads. You have access to my AI assistant, which is modeled after an Apple genius. And then you can also join any one of my webinars. I usually have two or three webinars a month, and you're able to join any one of those. And then last, you're helping support a small business. It's just me. I work out of a corner in my house. So if you become a member, you are helping support a small business. So that's how you can rename files on the Mac.